Dear students, in this lecture we will study some important water quality parameters. First the name, then type of the parameter, that means whether physical, chemical or biological, then acceptable limit for drinking purpose, then name of the test or apparatus, then its appearance or effect or result and remarks. Okay, first start with turbidity. It's a physical water quality parameter and it is measured by nephelometer, and unit is NTU, nephelometric turbidity unit. Acceptable limit is 1 NTU and its cause for rejection limit is 10 NTU. Okay, and it's and because of turbidity, water looks cloudy, that is cloudy appearance. Then pH, it is a chemical water quality parameter. Acceptable limit for drinking purpose is 6.5 to 8.5. It is measured by potentiometer. If it is less than 7 and acidic, equal to 7 means neutral, and greater than 7 means alkaline. Okay, then comes hardness. It is a chemical water quality parameter. Hardness means the concentration of multivalent metallic cations such as Ca2+, Mg2+, etc. Its acceptable limit is 300 mg per liter and its cause for rejection limit is 600. It is measured by EDTA method with the help of EBT indicator. EDTA means ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, and EBT indicator, that is erythrome black tea. And hard water means more soap consumption. Then suspended solid. It because of suspended solid, it aesthetically doesn't look good, so aesthetically displeasing, and it's a physical water quality parameter. Its limit is 30 mg per liter and it is removed by filtration technique. Then nitrate. Nitrate is a chemical water quality parameter and its limit is 45 mg per liter and it is measured by color matching technique. And effect of nitrate, if it is more than 45 mg per liter, then blue baby syndrome or methemoglobinemia can result. Okay, it is but remember, nitrite is more dangerous than nitrate. Okay, now fluoride. Fluoride is also a chemical water quality parameter, and its limit is 1 to 1.5. That is, the amount of fluoride in water should be effectively controlled. If it is measured by fluoride testing kit, if fluoride is less than 1 mg per liter, then it causes dental cavity. If greater than 1.5 mg per liter, then causes fluorosis. So the amount of fluoride in water should be controlled. And E. coli, that is coliform bacteria, it's a biological water quality parameter. It is measured by MPN technique. So, and its amount should be zero. That is, the presence of E. coli indicate the presence of pathogenic bacteria. So its amount should be zero. That means there is no pathogenic bacteria present in the water and it is safe for drinking. And in the test tube, if coliform bacteria is present, then it will generate carbon dioxide gas. So generation of carbon dioxide gas indicate the presence of coliform bacteria, which indicate the presence of pathogenic bacteria. That means the water is not safe for drinking. Then alkalinity is a chemical water quality parameter. Alkalinity means the ability of water to neutralize H+ ion, and it is measured by titration with an acid, generally 0.02 normal H2SO4, and its acceptable limit is 200 mg per liter and its cause for rejection limit is 600 mg per liter. And it causes incrustation of pipe. Actually, CaO3- reacting with Ca2+ causes CaCO3, and its precipitate in the pipe causes incrustation of pipe. Then taste and odor. It's a physical water quality parameter measured by TON, threshold odor number technique, and its desirable value is 1 TON and cause for rejection value is 3 TON. And it actually the water should be tasteless and odorless, but the elements which causes taste and odor of water are actually carcinogenic, that is causes cancer. And BOD, biochemical oxygen demand, it's a biological water quality parameter, and it measures the presence of biodegradable organic matter. So its amount should be zero, and it is measured by BOD bottle and 5 days by taking the 5 days BOD value at 20 degrees Celsius. Okay, so these are the important water quality parameters. Okay, thank you.